Listen, before you get on my ass, listen, Jerry's in the hospital right now, okay? Sorry we're late, but he's in the hospital, throwing up, sweating, weak in his arms and legs, can't use his left arm hardly or anything, and they're now transporting him to Asheville, over to the big hospital. He's got bleeding on his brain. Takes him a little while to answer a question. So something's definitely going wrong with the mind, with the brain. I don't know all the details yet, but Jerry's in pretty rough shape right now, and we're both in rough shape. Yeah, I guess I can go on here and check on this champagne myself while we wait to hear some news on what's gonna go on with Jerry. I always try to hope for the best. I just hope that he gets better. But he's got bleeding on the brain, and his blood pressure is at a stage that he should be dead at this point. But at this point, Jerry's with some very smart doctors, so I've got to just carry on. My wedding's coming up. I've only got a few more days left, you know, and the pressure's on, but I can't help but be thinking about Jerry. Yeah, this is mine and Jerry's champagne here. We're gonna get this ready for the wedding. I'll be speaking of the devil. That's old Jerry. Hey, buddy.
What's going on, man?
Playing with these champagne bottles like you asked me to. The biggest question is, how you doing?
I'm hanging in there, getting out there, just trying to figure out what's going on. Bleeding on the brain, trying to figure out why.
Oh, my God, man. That.
We got hooked up to all these digging machines and IVs and pumps and all kinds of gadgets and stuff.
Well, the main most important thing is you take care of yourself and get better and everything.
Do you know that champagne's important to you woman there? I want to make sure we get that taken care of. So continue on getting bottles ready so we get that process done.
I will. I'll do that, brother. But my biggest concern is you get better. I need you. You know, you're my brother. You're my other partner. You see what I'm saying?
I hear you.
I need you not to worry about all this.
But you know me. I want make sure stuff gets done.
I know you do.
Regardless of how shape I'm in.
You take care of yourself and keep me updated, okay?
All right, see you soon.
All right. He seems to be in real good spirits and talking, but you can tell he's weak and he's real tired. But there ain't no give up in him, that's for sure. That kind of lifts my spirits up a little bit, and we're going to make it happen. We're going to get this champagne ready for the wedding. Well, I guess I just got to get them upside down and vertical. Me and Jerry, we started the second fermentation on the champagne a while back, where we add our bubbles by adding the champagne yeast and sugar. Time to start rotating the bottles up vertically so that leftover champagne yeast will come to the neck of the bottle. Then when we freeze all that sediment right here in this neck, we take it, knock this cap off, blow the plug, and then cork it off. You definitely don't want nothing floating around in your champagne. That kind of turns people off. Yeah, you know, people want their champagne to be just as clear as it can be. It can have color to it, but it don't need to be cloudy. So I've got to just get this blueberry champagne finished, and that's what I intend to do. All right, we're good to go. Well, my initial plan is today is to fill these bins with ice. I've got to freeze all the necks of these champagne bottles, just the necks, so I can pull it out, knock the cap off, blow the frozen plug out, which contains all the settlement of the leftover yeast and particles that could have been left over into the wine. And then cork it off, put my wire cage on it, and she's ready to rock and roll. But first off, I want to give old Jerry a call. You know, me and Jerry's partners, we do this stuff together. We need each other. So I'm glad that he's able to communicate with me through phone. What's up, buddy?
Oh, I'm just laying here.
I got these bottles I wanted to show you.
Nice, perfect.
I got all the bottles upside down. I guess now, next thing is I'll just start freezing those necks.
I'm going to get a few bags of ice and have a little bit of salt. I want about 2 inches up the bottom neck.
They're about 2 inches?
2 inches on your neck, yeah.
Okay.
Now make sure you do it right.
I'm going to do it right.
Yeah, well, make me proud.
All right, brother, I'll do. See you, man.
All
right, bye-bye. Jerry's so hell-bent on me finishing it, I want it to be as perfect as I could ever possibly make it now. I can do it by myself. You know, it's always best if you have your partner here with you. And, you know, and the reason that he's actually away and gone is what's so heartbreaking to me. It's not because that he had something else to do or this and that and another or whatever. It's because of a health issue, a medical issue. But he wants me to carry forward. I'm carrying forward. Lay the salt to it. What the process is with the salt, you start the process of melting the ice, but it'll be colder than the freezing temperature of 32. It actually gets extremely colder. As soon as you put the necks of your champagne bottles in the icy, salty water, it's gonna immediately start to freeze the neck of that bottle. This is actually a two-man job, but we're gonna get this done. Before this freezes solid, I'm gonna get my boards. Gotta lift this up so I can get my ice bin under here. I'm gonna do this by myself, but we're gonna try it. I'm gonna have to get under here and... Yeah, I gotta be careful not to shake these things up too much. I'm gonna alternate sides here a little bit if I can. Gotta get it high enough so I can get my ice bin under here. Gotta bring the bottles up so I can slide the daggum ice bin under them. Got those two up now. Gotta put one more. I gotta try to get under this thing. Ugh. We're getting very close, but it's still a lot of process to take place for one man to do. But it's that time, and I'm gonna carry on. I'm gonna finish it. I got those elevated. Whew. Now, I'm gonna slide this under here. Now I need to take a board out at a time, I guess. And then I gotta bring them right back down. But you only want your neck sticking down the ice, because that's all you want to freeze, because that's where all your settlement's at, is in that neck. All I gotta do is wait for these things to freeze. Jake, I know he'd love to be there, but he can't be, and he's depending on me to do it. So you gotta figure it out for yourself, you know, sometime. Well, I'm sure. Oh, yes. We got a good plug of ice in there. We've got all the sediment from the yeast and particles and everything left behind that we do not want in our champagne froze right here in the neck of this champagne bottle. All right, we got to take the cap off, blow it out. It should blow the cube of ice out. I hope like so. Uh-oh, here we go. And sip it up, blow it out of there. It's froze too much. All we gotta do is get that to blow out. Oh, there we go. Boy, that was a good blower. There we go. We got champagne. Jerry's gonna be proud now. So you gotta be real, real quick. Get back to the table, cork it off, put the wire cage on it. There we go. We can lay her flat again. If you don't put the wire cage on it, it could blow the cork. Right there. There's the plug of ice that comes out of the champagne bottle. That's your yeast settlement right there. Then we got good, clean champagne. Yeehaw! I'm actually having fun popping these caps and plugging it off and putting the wire cages on. You know, I'm about to taste this champagne for the very, very first time. There's a whole hell of a lot riding on this right now. Calm down. Oh, my God. Jerry is gonna be proud of this. I tell you what, man, this stuff is phenomenal. It's got the blueberry coming through all the way. Woo, boy! We're right up there about the 12, 13% alcohol in there. I'm tickled to death. I can't believe it's turned out this way. Woo! You know, Jerry would love to be here right now to help me do this, but he's not. I just try to make it as fun as I can for myself. He'll be proud of my work that I've done and completed for both of us, and it's a win-win at the end. Oh yes, we're getting there.